Sabi niyo, sir, tayo naman sa DICT, connect, connect, connect. Satellite, internet, wifi, cellphone, connect everybody to each other. Especially our children, who because of the COVID, were forced to study from home.
Senator Honasan is good equally, and it is something which we can really recognize the persona behind the various names that we attach on his person. Senator Honasan, Greg, welcome to this short interview.
Thank you, sir.
Because I need to know. We seldom talk. We have not seen each other for quite a time. We seldom talk because I'm so busy winding up my affairs in my office. So hindi tayo na masyado nakikipag-ugnayan dito sa ating objectives ng yung grupo natin. For a starter, ano ang paningin mo sa itong population that will double in about 30 years, we would be maybe double our population. What is your long-term projection of this problem regarding school, health, and everything? And where would be the priority sa ating public funds spent on this problem? Education, pagkain, your take.
Mr. President, the first, maraming salamat po. Thank you for this opportunity. Sir, I start with what you yourself said. Our most precious strategic and renewable resource are our children, our next generation of citizens and leaders. So, protektahan natin sila. Now, I will go now to your question. Every 30 years po, our population doubles. So, yung mga bata ngayon, mga ilangan ng trabaho, yung mga nag-aral ngayon, mga ilangan ng eskwelahan, will need more government offices to service the population that doubles every 30 years. 1986, sir, 55 million tayo. Ngayon, 110 million. So ito, sir, yung tinatawag na long-term preparation that transcends your administration and the succeeding administrations. Pero, sir, the solution really is education. We prepare them. Now, sir, I will relate it to the job you gave me 2.5 years ago. Di ba, sir, meron kayong build, tulay, kalsada. Sabi nyo, sir, tayo naman sa DICT, connect, connect, connect. Satellite, internet, wifi, cellphone, connect everybody to each other. Especially our children who because of the COVID were forced to study from home. Kung nagbayad man, sir, wala signal. Sir, we are raising a new generation of future leaders and citizens who may be lagging behind in terms of global competitiveness. So that's my take, sir. And of course, sir, because of the COVID, we have a contracted fiscal space. Kunti na lang ang pera. It's also a sense of national priorities. Ito lang yun. Kayo rin, sir, nagsabing ito eh. Ito lang yung pera, saan natin gamitin? Ako, sir, ang take ko is gamitin sa mga bata. Prepare them. Now, you add, may COVID na, sir, nag-Ukraine pa yung problema. Di magtaas yung presyo ng gasolina. Everything follows. But my orientation, sir, my focus would be for future planning, development planning purposes, is our children. We prepare the next generation. That's as far forward as we can manage.
Tama ka. You know, we're getting old. We will be just in the wings waiting yung, well, not really about life or death, but somehow we have to give way to the I said, the youth that are just on the wing, they will be the sila yung yung present generation nila at that time would have to worry about also the next generation. Ayun ang generational ang ano natin eh. So you are right. We are here. We are part of governance. Everybody, you as senator, it's because we are preparing this world ng ating Pilipinas for them. In a few years, sila na. Five to seven years, we're out. So, they must have sama ka, education, and all. So, nasabi mo naman, I will be redundant to say it again. May ano lang ako, yung ito mo nung, ano, itong ating agriculture, we are an agricultural country. So, alam ko, malapit ito sa puso mo. How do we improve the economy natin vis-a-vis sa ating agricultural enterprises?
Ang proposal ko po, sir, is we work, we operate, that is sir, globalization, di ba?
Yes.
Import sir. Liberalization. Ang market natin is the globe. But with what is happening around the world, let's contract the situation a little. We operate on a 100-kilometer radius. Yung i-produce ng isang probinsya o barangay o municipality, bilhin ng gobyerno from the agricultural sector, especially food, and feed it to another barangay. So, it will be self-sustaining. It will be self-contained. No? It might spur the economy. But again, sir, I would like to add, alam mo, sir, yung farmer, yung agricultural sector, pag may extra na pera, hindi man, sir, ibili ng pagkain, ibili, sir, ng cellphone. Mm-hmm. Pag bili ka ng cellphone, you have now access to market information. Alam mo kung ano ang presyo ng produkto mo sa market.
Mm-hmm.
Automatic, sir, abolish na yung middleman na pumapatay sa kanila. So, totoo na, sir, yung farm to market.
Okay.
That's the way to. With technology, sir, cellphone, malaman mo na magkano ang presyo doon. Hindi ka na daan, sir, sa middleman. That would operate under the same ecosystem. No, self-contained, what one municipality or barangay produces, government will buy and feed it to the children of another barangay.
So, DICT command secretary for the longest time. Is this program thoroughly studied in the sense that it would be a workable, at least a part of the solution dito sa problema natin? We consume what we produce in the meantime.
Opo.
Because kulang man talaga, so we have to import rice. So is this a part of the yung program mo na would make it easy for everybody to move?
Yes, sir. Sir, I had the privilege of serving at people for 21 years in the Senate. Yung naiwan ko na trabaho doon, nung i-assign nyo ako as Secretary DICT, nadagdagan. I have now a new tool in my arsenal, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So, what we want to do, sir, basically, is yung legislative agenda ko, samahan ko na ng technology. What were your marching orders to me, sir, when I asked you? Sabi mo, connect government to other governments. Global and domestic. Local government, sir, ang frontline natin. Connect government to business. Employment. Productivity. Connect government to the citizens and everybody to each other. And I said, dinagdagan mo pa. Sabi, do this faster, cheaper, and in a more secure manner. Yun, sir, ang sinunod namin sa DICT.
Harnessing, well,
sir, so, if I may continue, harnessing the power of technology. Ano ba, sir, ang technology? Technology is to mawala na yung pila. Ang haba, sir, ng manual eh. Manual yung pirma, manual.
Yeah.
But with technology, we can speed it up. Because the critical variable we are managing is time.
Okay, that's good. It's a very good perception. How would you rate your performance when you were at DCT in improving all of these things that you are talking about?
Sir, I will not, baka naman sabihin, sir, kwan.
Go ahead. I believe in you.
Sir, let the figure speak for itself. When we took over, when your term started, sir, ang speed, internet speed natin, was 7 megabits per second. Ngayon, sir, 70.
Oh, that's right.
Tapos, sir, connectivity improved by 800%. Unprecedented, sir. But it is not to my credit. You gave us the objective, and we have a professional core in one of the newest departments. You know, sir, ang problema, we need to upgrade the understanding of government. That's the critical sector, sir, for the power of information and communications technology as a driving force for development. Okay lang, sir, pag-budget, dahil hindi man naintindihan, hindi, Juan, kunti ang tanong. Hindi lang, sir, maganda dahil hindi nila naintindihan, hindi, kunti lang yung budget. So, that's what we're grappling with, sir. But, sir, I understand this. Government is an ecosystem by itself. And to, di ba, sir, PPP, convergence, that's how we harness the power of government.
So, Greg, what's your... If you are elected again, which I hope you will be a senator, kasi kailangan ka ng bayan. Yung mga tao na tahimik, kagaya mo, you don't parade your achievements publicly. Not even a single word about. Ito yung iba, ako at ikaw, nakakaintindihan tayo niyan. We do not publicize what is the work that we are supposed to do and paid for. So, dyan ako humahanga sa iyo. Dyan kita sabi ko na kailangan ko yung mga tao na civilian na ako, kung nakikita ako, nagtatrabaho, na wala namang yabang, walang publicity. Let the, what you see is... the work that I have done. And you have done a tremendous improvement in your term sa DICT. I understand that. I know it. Alam ko yan. Para lang ito sa mga tao. Now, how do you meet the challenge now na paliit ng paliit yung langis natin? So, with this, if there is a prolonged strife there in Europe, or it would go overboard at mag it would be an expanded quarrel amongst the EU and Russia and the rest, and it might spill over dito sa, because China will not just stand idly there to see an important ally which has because a long connection with each other. Paano mo if there's a wag sana, but I think if this it would go overboard and it will engulf Europe, how do you assess the situation and how would we survive actually?
Sir, with all due respect, it has already spilled over. Nagigirian pa lang sila noon, umakyat na yung presyo ng gasolina. So ang immediate na proposal po namin, sir, ko is automatic price adjustment. Pag akyat ng presyo ng langis, bawasan natin yung buwis para kumita yung gobyerno, pero wag pahirapan yung tao. That's would be my approach, sir, no? Immediate. Second, sir, if you look at the map, yung Philippines, sir, ang may hawak ng traffic light. Dito dumadaan yung eroplano, yung barko, yung submarine pa siguro, sir. No? We must harness that potential. Ayusin natin yung sarili natin. Ang problema, sir, eh. Ito, panahon ng eleksyon. Ang kaaway is food, clothing, shelter, education, health services, access to information. We are fighting each other. So, dapat, sir, we must harness that potential. We fix our own backyard so that we can harness this potential. We can be the digital, the economic, the social, the cultural hub, not only of the Pacific area, but of the world. Yung nahihirapan na bansa, sa atin pupunta dahil maganda ang patakaran natin. Now, moving forward, sir, Ako sir, why did you convince me to run? And why did I agree? Because sir, I want to help protect the good programs of your administration and previous administrations. Ang nawala sa atin sir, bagong presidente, bagong medium term policy, bagong kung ano-ano man. So, perpetually stuck into medium term planning. We must develop a sense of long term planning. 50-year development plan tayo sir. So, our problems that is causing some instability in policy is lack of sustainability, continuity, and policy predictability. We want to introduce that by strengthening the institutions. So, tingin mo sir yung mapa. Di ba sir, one time, cabinet meeting, you raised the issue of Facebook. Galit na galit kayo sir sa Facebook. Sabi namin sir, advice, sir, huwag kayong galit, negosyo lang yan. Landing yung Facebook sa Baler, tawid from Baler to Puro Point, bagay sir, sa Baler, US. Sa kabila, naghintay yung China and Japan. Dadaan, sir, sa teritoryo natin. Crossing Luzon. Ibayad sila, sir. Daan ka sa tollgate tayo. That's how I think we should plan for additional revenue generation, which is actually part of your program for this.
Kung senador ka na, maasahan ba namin na you would work on this problem, the intricacies of how it is done, so that we will benefit from all of these things, as you have said, because we seem to be placed in the planet parang crossing ito between the Pacific and Asia.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would push for that. But again, sir, the Senate, alam mo naman, sir, that's 24 independent republics. We must develop a consensus. Sir, we have a mechanism for that already, which happened during the time of President Ramos, the LEDAC, Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council, where you hammer out the common agenda that is a product of the legislative and the executive. Meron pa nga, sir, proposal na isama na yung judiciary para pag may constitutional issues, di, ayusin na kagad. Madalas ang meeting para the agenda is monitored.
No. Which has not been followed religiously dito.
Except because you're busy with important things, urgent things.
Yes, well, it's because sometimes of really politics. Itong politika nga. But if we can have you there, you being a neutral, parang sa political leanings, maasahan ba namin ito sa iyo? I'm sure that you have enough gray matter between your ears to do that, but I said, how would you handle the politics that governs all of these things? Even, calling a guy from the executive department to talk to you there in a common ground. Paano magawin yan?
Sir, first of all, that is the reason why I have remained independent. No offense, sir, to those who are members of parties, no? But sir, from where I sit, my experience in the legislative executive branch, political parties do not exist in this country. It's temporary coalitions. So I think, sir, one effort should be to strengthen the political party system para klaro yung plataforma at programa. Mag-usap-usap kung ano ang common ground. Now, sir, to develop a consensus, if I may suggest, bakit, sir, ang daming komentaryo tungkol sa administration ninyo? Because you have opted to manage time by moving towards executive action. Ibigay mo yan, sir, sa committee. Di ba, sir? How not to solve a problem, you give it to a committee. So, executive action. I think, sir, even the legislative must develop a sense of executive action. Bawasan ng konti yung debate hearing, focus on the common agenda, and then push it using the power of the three branches of government.
If maganda yun. I think that the judiciary, we are independent of each other, but you in the Senate, ako dito. But it would be good to just invite the judiciary also to, because somehow there would be things that would crop up that the legislative branch of government should be aware of, na hindi na kailangan yung the endless debate because we have not agreed on this project. We are not in consonance with the proposal of the other. You're right.
Sir, if I may add, to my mind, sir, it's my humble opinion, the Philippine presidency, not the Philippine president, is one of the most powerful, if not the most powerful presidencies among the remaining presidential democracies. If you recall, sir, one conversation, sir, what do you need to make a difference? You have a supermajority in the Senate, in the House. You have command and control over three legally authorized armed groups, the AFP, the PNP, and the NBI. You are going to appoint 10 Supreme Court justices. Ano pa, sir, ang kailangan? So, that power should be harnessed. But again, sir, having said that, no matter how powerful the president, the Philippine presidency is, he cannot do it alone. You have to do this together.
It should be a coordinate branch of government. Kaya nga.
Sir, kinolor code pa natin yung politics natin. We color coded each other. Philippine team tayo. Hindi tayo...
I understand you. And I understand your neutral stance all along. And to your credit, pati sa akin, is we never called each other. We never talk. This is the first time that I've talked to you only in front of the TV because the people have the right to know what you're going to do. Since para sa akin, you will be re-elected. Para malaman lang yung tao, I am really supporting you to the hilt. That's why pinatawag kita para pag-usapan kung anong magandang gawin para sa bayan.
Sir, if I may, as you're
concerned.
Your permission, sir. Di ba, sir, we would talk in the same manner, in private. I don't think the TV cameras talk this way. Di ba, sir, may rule na if you want to be a real human being, what you think, what you say and what you do must be the same. Unfortunately, politics has introduced that what you think is different from what you say and different from what you do. Well, between us...
Kung ang senador kagaya mo lang, hindi walang problema. Hindi naman siguro alam ng tao, but way back, long ago, I was... when this was this revolution and all, yung panahon, yes, days past, siguro hindi alam ng tao na ni-recruit ninyo ako sa RAM. That all along, I was one of the few city mayors na who were with RAM. Hindi alam ng tao yon. Because we talk and maybe think on the same wavelength. Kaya ang kung tayo lang of our likes, kindred, comradeship, di madali sana. Eh, kaso nga sabi mo yung politika and the political system, sir. So, I would like to ask you now to just narrate the others itong feeding the program at saka itong yung automatic reduction ng ano nakuha na natin yung poverty alleviation na lang yung economic same but I can almost guess what you would like to say,
sir. This is my humble opinion, sir. The first responsibility of any government is order. Nasa lugar lahat. And if we are to introduce some sense of order and strategic planning, kaya sir, may feeding program. We have to feed our children properly between the ages of 0 to 6. Pag hindi mo, sir, pinakain niya ng tama, after 6, we may be raising unconsciously, unintentionally, a new generation of mentally retarded Filipinos. Is suppose, sir, one of those people become president or senator?
That's scary.
Scary, sir. Yeah, Mandores. Kunik-kunik niya, sir. Paano mo mapakain niya ng gatas or breastfeeding kung yung nanay malnourished. Bakit malnourished yung nanay? Jeepney driver yung asawa na walang trabaho. Connected na lahat yan, sir. But the focus should be our children. That's our most precious resource. That's what we agreed, sir, yun. Fight, live, or die for.
Yan nga ang pinapag-usapan natin noong panahon ng RAM days natin. Was really, although it was not, but there was an improvement when we urged government at that time to reform, otherwise face this consequence. Napag-usapan natin yan at alam ko on all counts that tama ka. So, I'd like to just, before we end this short interview, what you intend to do when you go back to the Senate after the elections?
Sir, too late in the day para sumipsip pa ako sa inyo. So, I just follow what you did by example. We will continue to dream, to pray, and to work hard for the country, for God, country, and our families, especially our children.
That's good. That's nice. Ganon talaga ang fervor mo na rinig ko noon pa. When you recruited me sa RAM, hindi ito alam ng lahat. Mayroon pa akong yung ating...
A guardian, sir.
We all have the same tatak. We recognize each other as members of the Brotherhood. Pero yung RAM was ultra secret because as a matter of fact, there was a simple ritual na ginawa ninyo. And first of all, yung omerta was, you honor the omerta or you die. Well, it was a very stringent thing, but it helped in the end. Kasi hindi nila alam na wanted ka. Pero nagmamotor tayo sa Dabao, umiikot tayo. And the funny thing is that while you were supposedly hiding, nagmamotor tayo, others opted to use the helmet. Ikaw, nagtanggal ka ng helmet, they nagtanggal lahat. And to think that there was not even a whimper na ang hinahanap ninyo na dito sa Dabao, nagpapasyal-pasyal ni... So, with Noble and everybody. Well, I remember those days, but they are no longer, they are just memories. Ang importante is what we do in the present. So, thank you for your narratives. It's still good. It was good when you began it with RAM. And it has still very good until now, no doubt about it. I said fervor has not changed, so that's why we would need you in the Senate, and you have my full support. Magkakampanya talaga ako. I'm campaigning for you in every speech that I am. I hope that we'll make it God's will. And continue your work because ika nga, the work is not done yet. It's not finished. So it's a process that would transcend to the next generation. So gawain natin yung para atin. You'd stay longer. I hope that the next 6 years would be a productive year for you, yes, for you and everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It's an honor, sir.